to moving from this box to this double. I may break some rules here and just move the entire five frame with whatever below it straight into here. It's double deep. I've got plastic foundation ready to go. And the reason I'm considering doing it that way is because I know extensive it is. So this is where it gets to be the fun part. Really need two people on this. And I really need my shoulder under it, because that is heavy. Okay. And all things considered, they are behaving themselves supremely. Look for the queen. I do not see a queen. Oh, there's a beetle. They're corralling those beetles too. Get them, girls. There's a couple of dead beetles. Wow, they are thick. This is going to be a challenge. I think what I'm going to do is turn this sideways and set this beside it and just try to work it that way. It's more prudent to have them out of here earlier than later. They're just so thick in there. Unbelievably thick. Not all interested in moving. That's hilarious. I wonder if I can get them out. If I can get one out, it makes it a lot easier. Note to self, make these things deeper. Not deeper, wider. I need at least half a frame gap in here or something. Maybe a removable board on the inside. It's not bad. Good brew pattern. Dropping some honey in the bottom. Oh, so it broke off. Okay. They got a lot of honey in the bottom, unfortunately. There's honey on the back side of this. So let's just go on with plan A. Of course, if that's just honey, I can cut it off. I think I'm just gonna let it have it. I'm afraid of what's in the bottom. I should have screwed this together. It would have made my life a lot easier. All right, they're getting defensive now. I hate to tear up the comb underneath, it was my fault. I'll give them as much a chance as I can, Lord willing, as much as possible will come. I should have done a better job. Broke some off on this one too. They crossed it at the bottom. That's the problem. In the bottom it's crossed up. I never would have gotten these out. And it's a lot of honey. So the brood's up top. Yeah, just got a beetle by accident. That's cool. Only thing in my favor is I'm dealing with evening time. Keep your frames in order, right? Actually, the bees didn't follow the instructions. They're written on the side of the box right there underneath that cluster. It says, clearly states, draw out your comb in the frame. If for some reason you run out of frame, draw out your comb directly below the frame above and do not go side to side like this. So, my bad. And their bad. I didn't follow the instructions I laid out. So anywho, I need to get this. Bees are circling looking for their hive. I'm torn about cleaning up this comb as I go or deal with it later, right? Nice thing about in the bottom, they're secured to the walls. So when they give, they don't collapse on each other. Gives them pretty good framework to work with. The only problem here is I've got screen to deal with. Breed on this side. I'll be. These are agitated big time. I got one queen cup. Well, at least the brood are in the top. I'm looking for the queen, if you're wondering why I'm staring at a frame of bees. I'm just glad to put onion in the bottom and not on the top.
That'd be really messed up if I was leaving right behind. Yeah, I moved my hand too fast. But she bounced off the nitrile. She don't like nitrile. And I'm trying to move bees out of a completely populated, beautifully populated. I hate to do this to them. And that's just gorgeous. What a gorgeous. And their temperament is fantastic. I mean, I've been walking in front of this thing for, I mean, look how thick that is. Goodness gracious, this is a good set of bees. And honestly, I'd rather them build out the bottom of that straight off of there and never pull these frames ever again, just work out of the top unless there's a problem. But, you know, you're supposed to be able to make these things removable so they can be inspected. Why do you need to inspect bees? Well, you need to make sure you have a laying queen. Got multiple hives, which if you're getting started, that propolis is sticking to my gloves. If you're just getting started, you want at least two hives, and I moved too fast and one of them darted at me just now. Get yourself a J hook. Move too fast. It helps to pry. It doesn't take much. I'm just trying to break at least from the comb underneath because I can't. Ding dongs in there, cross combed everything. And I'm trying to do it gently so that I don't press bees against the in between frames because I've got a queen somewhere in this box. And I don't know if she's been moved yet or not. Loose. One bee go down, pop me on my foot. In theory, the queen won't be on honey, right? And if you can, get you a board to pry against as you're doing this. All right, so I got the bottom of two frames clean, and I think I just pinched a bee. I might get stung here. FYI, they haven't stung me yet, but normally they don't go through that nitrile unless they're really pissed at something, like, I don't know, you're tearing up their house. No, but I'm trying to give them a good, a better deal, bigger, better deal, right? All I can see is honey. I see a little pollen. And I think I can drive them out using BeeQuick in the top board, the inner cover. Put them back over there where they were. Put this on top. and then drive them out into the new hive. That's the theory that I'm gonna work with. First thing I wanna do is clean off the bottom of these combs, get the honey off the bottom of those three remaining. Now the tricky part. Alright. So, in theory, that's going on the original cover. I'm going to try to drive them out of the top into this. I hope it works. I might have to do something to give them cover, otherwise they're going to get robbed. So this is, you know, running out of daylight. Western sky. Sun's gone. I don't know what time it is. I started this mess, I don't know, somewhere after 6. So, you know. In theory, this can clear honey super really efficiently, so. It's apparently, bees don't like the smell of it. And I'm gonna apply it liberally to the inner cover. And in theory, that'll make all of them run out. And only one place to go. Let's see what happens. That's that. Oh, look at them come out. They're like, get out, get out, get out. See them barreling out of there now? That's what you want to see. That bee quick is getting them out of there. I need them to go down, not up. So that's where I need my brush. That's the way I want to see it right there. Like someone turned the lights on in the kitchen at night. Not my house, but you know, I hear it on the movies all the time. Maybe I should spray the box too, huh? The nitrile gloves thinking, you know, dog. They know better than getting close to this in the wrong sense. Anyway, maybe I should quit brushing. What do you think? Some of them are going down in the hive like I want them to. It would have been a lot easier to put this on top of the other hive body, but I'm working with what I got. They're still coming out. So they don't like that smell. But, you know, on the plus side, it's almost dark. It helps me to not have to deal with the robbing bees. But they're probably about all out of there. And I can't do this all night. I need to get that comb out of there. And I need to utilize what daylight I have left. So I gotta find me a good bucket to put this in, because I guess I'm crushing and straining honey tonight too, since I can't frame that stuff up. They're exiting still. Reluctantly, but they are. So I'll show you the results after I get the charge on this thing. Have a good one.
The whole box was brood. Very little drone brood, but there was some drone brood. I was amazed that the bottom part was drawn brood comb. There was very little pure honeycomb. There was plenty of honey in there, but not so much that I couldn't frame it up. You know, typical configuration where the honey was at the top part of the frame or comb, pollen, bees, brood. They're doing a pretty good job figuring out what's going on. The ones at the top are circling around. They're figuring it out. Within a day or two, they'll figure this out completely. Only got stung once yesterday framing up brood in the palm of my hand, which that's not fun, but it's part of the game.